Hello, today we are going to study about a method in social science, which you all are aware, you must have heard it a number of times, that is the field trip. And most of the times when you say a field trip, you see the joy on the face of the students, right? So this is a very important strategy, method which you may use, you know, in the teaching of social science. For learning to be meaningful and joyful, it is important that students are exposed to worthwhile experiences such that they are able to relate to what is being taught. In social sciences, field trips are particularly useful as through them, students are able to view and analyze social realities from different perspectives. Now, when you say it is a field trip, what exactly do you mean by a field trip? Let us look at the definition which has been given by the Collins Dictionary in English. A field trip is a trip made by the students and a teacher to see or study something, for example, a museum, a factory or a historical site. Okay, there may be other places which you may also visit. But essentially, if you see, there is a clear purpose to see or study something. That means we are not talking of it as something which has entertainment value. We are talking of it as something which is to be observed, which is to be used as something which is a learning experience. So this is very, very important for us to understand. Now, when you talk of a field trip, it's very, very important that you understand how exactly should be a field trip be organized as a teacher. How a successful field trip may be organized. And for that, there are different steps which we need to take care of, right? If a field trip is organized very meticulously and it is planned very carefully, there is no reason that it will not be a successful learning experience and an enjoyable learning experience. For it to be successful, it is very, very important that you go through certain stages. The first being planning. In the beginning of the year itself, you may look into the textbook and syllabus and identify the chapters that can go well with the field trip. On which theme, which is the concept, which is the event, which you would like it to be covered through a field trip. Depending on the availability of time and resources, select a few places for the field trips. It is very, very important that this planning is done way ahead. After selection, fix the tentative time of visit. Take permission from the concerned people, authorities, parents. And it's very, very important that you also have a clear knowledge that with reference to when you're going to a place, you have to note the timings of the place of visit. You have to see which are the times where that places may be closed, so on and so forth. Prepare the students for the visits. Guide them as to what to observe, what to note down. If possible, prepare a questionnaire and give it to each child. So you have a clear planning on ground to be done for a field trip, where the students are well aware why they are undertaking the trip, what they may observe there. Okay, give them clear questions for which they have to find answers through that field trip. Then only it becomes a field trip which becomes and essentially a good learning experience. Now, execution of the trip. As per the plan, go on a field trip along with the students and colleagues. See that all children participate actively. Okay? And take proper care of the children. It's very, very important. It's a responsibility which the teacher has on his or her shoulders. So, we have to execute the trip on absolutely with reference to the laid down plan. Now, when I'm talking of the laid down plan, that means that there's a time at which you start the trip, the transportation, the permissions, everything needs to be worked out clearly. See that all children participate actively is also very, very important. There is no child who should be feeling left out or alienated. If you do not give responsibilities or involve all the children, they do feel let down. So it's important that you involve all the students while you take them for a field trip. Now, once it has been executed, we'll go into the details of all these steps later, but I'm just giving you the main steps before this. Follow up. After returning from the field trip, consolidate the experiences with the help of students. That means a discussion has to be held with reference to what they learned from this field trip. Okay? It has to be a part of their continuous assessment. Relate their experiences to the chapter. Okay, for example, suppose you take them to a field trip to the parliament. Let them see the proceedings of the Lok Sabha or Rajya Sabha in India, which they've seen, the upper house and the lower house. And now give them questions as to what they saw there, What are the how they feel, what they learned from that experience? What were the security measures? How was the who was conducting the proceedings of the house? What are the role of the different members? So on and so forth. So organizational part has to be looked at, and in the follow-up, you have to ask the students what they learned from it. And very important, you know, in the follow-up, you also need to ask them what exactly, what the shortcomings of the trip, right? So that the next field trip which you plan has to be better than the first one. Now, you may also ask the students to write their experiences of the field trip in the form of a reflective journal, where they reflect on their own experience, their learnings from the field trip, and they write their experiences in a reflective journal. Now, let us look at few important aspects of a field trip. First is student involvement. Two major distinctions exist between just going somewhere as a class and taking a field trip. These distinctions are very clear, and let us, you know, recapitulate them. The trip is linked to the established curriculum. That means there is a purpose for which the trip is being undertaken, right? And depending upon what is the purpose of that trip, you are taking the students for this field visit, right? Students are involved, secondly, in data gathering while on the trip. That means they are not just spectators looking at things while they're not even understanding what is going on around them. It's not a pleasure trip. It is a field trip. They are going for a study to observe things. How can students take an active role in data gathering? You have to ensure this during the field trip. These are answers which you have to ensure beforehand so that the students are involved. The answers to questions involved in setting the stage can provide guidance, and the students' developmental levels should be taken into consideration. That means you have to see which kind of field trip will fit for which age group of students. For example, while visiting a local cemetery, young children can produce rubbings of gravestone, names and dates, and older children might interview the caretaker and copy epitaph to compare with relevant historical sources back in the classroom. On a tour of a historical downtown street or area, young children might be asked to match and tally architectural types, and older children might produce sketches or photographic essays. So depending upon what is the age group of the students, you have to give them the field assignment related to that. At factory or any other place of business, young children may observe specific workers at their task with instructions to role play or draw what they learned upon returning to the classroom. Older children can look for instances of interdependence among workers or make notes describing specific skills or knowledge required for particular jobs. So that means the teacher has to be very, very clear that if it's a mixed age group, how will I, you know, what will they exactly do in this particular field trip, and how am I going to manage this experience for them? By managing this experience for them, that means how do I make this experience more fruitful and meaningful for the learners such that they feel involved, right? Moving further, with reference to setting the stage, we talked about student involvement. Now let us see how do we set the stage of this field trip. Once the curriculum foundations have been laid and all arrangement for the field trip itself have been made, the next step is to prepare the students for the field trip. Why are we going to this particular site? If it's an industrial visit, why are we undertaking this industrial visit? If we are going to the parliament, what exactly are we supposed to visit that for? What is the purpose of this visit? What do we hope to learn there? These are certain questions the students should ask themselves and each other, such that they have clarity with reference to the purpose of the field visit. Prepare your students to learn more while on the field trip by introducing these questions to them, related topics and related materials, some days or weeks in advance of the trip. A trip becomes fruitful and meaningful if this planning is done very meticulously by the teacher in planning the field trip. And teachers use a variety of methods for introducing a field trip topic to their students. And at the very least, you should discuss the objectives of the trip. Why are we going and what do we hope to learn? This is a very, very important question which students need to know, that there is a purpose of going and there are certain things which we hope to learn in this field trip, right? Create a bulletin board, an interest center or other instructional display to spark interest and encourage students to think about this site. For example, as I said, you're going to the parliament or you're going to a factory visit or you're taking them for a field visit to look at, for example, the pasteurization of the milk in the place where the milk is being, produced. So it's very, very important. If you're taking them for a field trip, what is the purpose? What are they going to see there? Right? Have a bulletin board. Collect the different news items on that particular aspect. And let them, this will spark their interest and curiosity, right? And make them think. Now, make a field trip web just as you use a story web or thematic web. A field trip web can help focus thinking and raise questions which can be answered during the trip. Very, very important. Draw a large circle on a piece of butcher paper or light-colored bulletin board paper. Write the place or topic of the field trip in the circle with bold markers. Draw spokes or lines coming from the circle. Invite students, very, very important, to brainstorm on related topics or questions in small groups. The think, pair, share activity works very well here. And suggest labels for the spokes, right? You may suggest labels for the spokes or the students, when they are brainstorming on these different aspects of the field trip, they may fill in the spokes outside the circle. Develop a list of questions to be answered and have students decide which questions can be best answered through the preliminary research and which can be answered best on site during the field trip. So you have to develop two set of questions. One, which fuel their curiosity with reference to the field trip, and one, the answers to which they find on the site visit during the field trip. These both, the one is fueling their curiosity, making them feel interested in the field trip. The second set of questions is that they find answers to during the undertaking of the field trip. Assign topics to be researched from the preliminary research list so that all the students are involved, and assist groups as they look for relevant resources or reference materials. Then set a date near the date of the field trip, as close to the actual date as possible, for groups to present their findings to the class. That means before undertaking the field trip, they have already done the preliminary research with reference to what they are going to observe, what they are going to find, how this field visit will be beneficial to them, what kind of learning experience do they foresee, so on and so forth, right? So have this brainstorming before the final field trip is undertaken, right? And this should be done as close to the actual date, such that they are able to relate to this brainstorming event during their field trip. Moving further, about the planning of the field trip, avoid snags and disappointments through careful planning. This is very, very important. Much of the necessary field trip planning and related communication takes place with persons outside the classroom environment. Now, the following steps present a thoughtful guide for successful field trip planning. First, make contact with key persons at the field trip site as early as possible, because you have to see whether that field trip is possible on that particular date, so that you can make necessary arrangements. Then, follow up an arrangement made by phone with a written letter summarizing your request, your preferred dates for the field trip, number of students and chaperones involved, including yourself and the bus driver in the final count, and special needs such as handicapped access or deviations from the expected tour. Ask for a response in writing to finalize arrangements and avoid misunderstandings on the day of the field trip, right? Everything has to be done in writing such that there is crystal clarity with reference to both the parties, that undertaking the field trip and the people who are going to welcome you on the site of the field trip, so that everything is planned as per the itinerary which you have already, formulated for your students. Now, delegate responsibilities. Find out whether any other teachers at your institution or nearby institutions are planning a field trip to the same site. If so, negotiate which jobs can be split. For example, suppose you have to, one institution can take care of the transportation. The other institution can take care with reference to the hospitality arrangements, right? So this responsibility can be shared, and you can negotiate with reference to what suits each other, and you can work out future arrangements. Then you arrange transportation. Make any arrangements needed to reserve transportation and drivers as early as possible. Finalize transportation arrangements in writing with copies to both the transportation department and to the designated driver. It is very, very important that everybody is involved in this loop such that last minute cancellations or embarrassments are avoided. Very important, the next step, send home parental permission slips early. Follow up on these if necessary. It is very, very important that you get the parental permission in writing. It is best to take extra permission slip copies the first time, since students often lose their form on the way home or forget to bring the signed copy back. So that is very, very important. Make arrangements for box lunches, lunch boxes, or stopping for lunch at a restaurant near the field trip site. This is also very, very important that you identify if you are having lunch on the way, which is the restaurant which you are going to have the lunch at. Inform them in advance so that they are prepared with reference to the number of people who are going to come with reference to that particular date, such that the eats are ready and there is no wastage of time. Collect necessary fees, okay? And ask the parent and teacher group to provide scholarship for those students who cannot afford the fees. Or there may be other arrangements which you can see. For example, you may have the student welfare department looking at the scholarship, okay? And you can find those scholarships such that all the students are able to undertake this field trip, just in case the cost of the field trip is a little unaffordable side. This is very, very important that every student who wishes to undertake this field trip, because it is at the end of the day, it is a learning experience which the student has to undertake. So it's very important that all of them are involved and no student is left behind because of any kind of financial implications. Moving further, establish rules for proper field trip behavior prior to the day of the trip. It's very, very important that you tell them well in advance what is the kind of behavior which is expected of them, right? Instruct, for example, if you are going to places or heritage sites, you would definitely not like your students to be well behaved, in the sense no hooting, no whistling, no loud noise. For example, if you are taking them to an arts gallery, you expect them to look at art, to understand the nuances of different art forms, but you do not expect them to be loud or noisy there, right? So you have to instruct them clearly. Print out a copy, take a printout and mail to all parent volunteers as well before the big day, that is the day of the field trip, and have extra copies on hand, in hand on the day of the trip. Distribute it to the helpers and drivers as well. Ask everyone involved to cooperate by enforcing these rules consistently. Keep track of students, very, very important. Count the heads before leaving the institution, at the restroom stop if needed. If a student has gone to the restroom, you have to see whether the student has returned, right, at the field trip site. And before departing the field trip site, you also need to count the number of students. Students can help keep track of each other if you use the buddy system. That means you have one student responsible for the other students in pairs, right? So they take care of the buddy. So buddy system can work very well with reference to keeping a track of all the students. So the students will tell you whether their buddies are there or their buddies are missing. And then don't forget to bring camera and film to create memories of the trip. It is very close to the heart of students, so it's very important that you showcase these memories in future as well. Students themselves may benefit from planning and taking photographs of important sites or processes during the trip itself. You know, it becomes a learning experience after you share this experience further, right? Now, after the field trip, we understand that the field trip has taken place successfully, meaningfully, and it has been enjoyable for the learners, right? But it's very, very important, what do you do after the field trip? An excellent window of learning opportunity exists immediately after the field trip. Students are primed for learning. Don't let the opportunity pass. Plan post-field trip instruction before the trip and write down as much of the plan as possible, especially helpful in case of a substitute is needed. Some ideas for post-field trip instructions include discussion based on the field trip web. What did we want to learn? What did we learn? What information do we still need to know? How can we find out? Look at photographs taken during the trip. Go to a one-hour photo developer if possible, as the kids will be very anxious to see the pictures as you are. Talk about what was happening in each one. Create a class scrapbook, if possible, of the field trip, using anecdotal comments and descriptions written by students to accompany the photograph. It makes very interesting, when each photograph has the description of what they learned. What was their experience? What was their reflection on seeing this particular thing? Ask, can you draw what the photo might have looked like? Include these with appropriate anecdotes in the scrapbook. It becomes a memory, and it also becomes a learning experience for a lifetime. They can go back to these experiences and, you know, recapitulate them time and again, right? Making the learning more concrete. And also, write thank you letters to the key persons on the site, the drivers, the chaperones. Depending on the age of your students, the letter recipients would probably appreciate original drawings of field trip experiences to display for co-workers. Create a hallway display communicating to other classes what was learned during the field trip, so that other students are also able to understand or learn from this field trip, and they are also excited about taking this field trip in future. Invite students to respond to the field trip with a project that uses art, drama, or music in accordance with the multiple intelligences model. Every student may not be very good in art, may not appreciate art, may not be very interested in art. That student may be interested in drama or music. So you have to cater to multiple intelligences such that the students are able to respond to their field trip experiences. Students could write and perform an original song, compose and recite an original poem, draw or paint a picture, sculpt a figure, write a story or essay, develop and perform a skit, create a mobile poster or collage, compose and perform a rap, and so on. If slide film was used, have students work together to create a slideshow, complete with the narration, musical background, introduction, and conclusion. As a teacher, you can help them with reference to, you know, preparing this slideshow or a collage or so on and so forth, with reference to the collection of different materials. Now, as you plan your next trip, remember to make curriculum connections. We have to be very clear that this trip has been undertaken such that the students' experiences become more meaningful, more connections are established with reference to what they've learnt in theory. So that is very, very important, that these curriculum connections are made through this field trip. Plan for students to be involved in active data collection. Introduce students to the purposes and objectives of the trip. Make advanced preparations for permissions. This is a recapitulation of the entire process of planning a field trip. For permissions, transportation, meal and beverages, plan for field trip follow up once students are back in the classroom. And have a plan B for the day in case of rain or cancellation. Suppose you're going by bus and the streets are flooded. What would you do? You would require a cancellation, but have a backup plan in place that what would you engage the students in case there is an emergency or an exigency, right? So you have to have a plan B in place such that there is no panic and the students also don't feel disappointed in case of an cancellation, which was absolutely unavoidable. Make arrangements for photographs and for videotaping. Collect student-centered resources and reference materials and check the internet for related websites. Most of all, please remember that you have to make this field trip a memorable learning experience for them, right? A memory which they will not forget, a memory which is a lifetime memory, and a memory where you have achieved the goals of curriculum with reference to the concepts which you were taught using field trip as a method. It is very, very important that in social sciences, field trips are used wherever possible such that when they learn through their experiences of going to the field, it becomes a concrete experience and thus they remember more and their learning is something which is transferred to different life situations and they are able to successfully understand the different nuances of the concepts which you tried to elucidate through this field trip. It's very, very important, therefore, that the field trip is meticulously planned such that every learner is involved. All the preparations are done in advance, right? And the students have clear clarity with reference to why they are undertaking the trip, what is the objective of the trip, what will they learn, what are they expected to learn. And after coming back, let them also be involved in a critical learning session where, you know, they think about, okay, how could we have achieved to plan this field trip in a better way, okay? How would this field trip become a more memorable experience had we planned it a little differently? It's very, very important that you have a follow-up session on the field trip as well. You know, If you have a follow-up session and a feedback session, it will help you to have the future field trips which are more productive, more meaningful, more joyful, and which become learning experiences for a lifetime. So it's very, very important that you plan a field trip such that it becomes a memorable and joyful learning experience. Thank you very much. I hope you all use field trips as learning methods in social sciences and make them memorable experiences for your learners.